Hello, I've been thinking about making a video for a while now, and I think now is probably a good time to start as any. So, I wanted to talk about a little project I've been working on, and I've actually been working on it for quite a while, because it started with a concept. After that, we were designing a plan, and now we actually have got electronics ready, or ready-ish. I didn't start the project, but it's a pretty cool one. I sadly cannot tell you everything about it, but I'll show you some things. I'll hope that'll be good enough. So, the heart of this project is actually not all of this electronics you see here, but is this, which is a vector optics distance measured device. What I've done here is, as you see these wires going, I am sniffing the information that the distance measuring device is sending to its liquid crystal display. After I get the device, after I get the information, I decode it and I send it onwards to my controller board. Now my controller board is actually having a stepper driver and LEDs and everything, also buttons. And I am having a little test code on it. As you can see, we are looping and we are waiting for a button input. Now, as I press button input, we're going into distance measuring. We measure distance and we display this distance. But not only do we measure and display the distance, but we actually had the stepper motor turning according to the distance we measured. At the moment the stepper motor is just turning I think it was 60 times of the number we get in meters. That's pretty nice. So what do we have here on the LCD? On the board we have a stepper driver. We have button inputs. For some weird reason, I thought that having lots of grounds is as good as having one, but I'm not very sure why. Anyways, the stepper code is working pretty nice, as you saw it. I can show it again. It'll take a moment time, because we're making a distance measuring of, with the machine, and also decoding everything. And we got the distance, and we were moving. We go onwards and backwards. I've got a pretty nice library for that. So, maybe people are a bit more interested in what I have here in the lab. This is my power box. There I've got my other stuff waiting in there. Of course, everybody needs a trash bin. We've got component boxes. More component boxes. Two of the Agilent U1232 A multimeters. Actually, one is not the big one. One is 1231A. Technically, I was having low on money at the moment when I was buying these, and I wanted a good thing. Agilent is a good thing to buy. Also, a no-name brand LC meter. More component boxes. A huge ass carrying case. A DSO Nano with updated firmware. I actually got to update it a bit ago. One other project of mine, which I will be talking about some other time later. And something else interesting, that is probably more interesting than the most of the things you saw right a moment ago. Here is a Texas Instruments RF module development kit. And what do we have here? Shitload of things, and not just shitload of things, but shitloads of awesome things. As you can see, radio module development kit, also a kit with a component with the ready USB port. I'm sorry for the low quality of this video, but at some time I will get better video camera and I will show you a better video as well. Anyways, I hope this was fun and I hope that you like my video blog, because for some weird reason I kind of like doing this more. But the probably main reason is that I really suck at English grammar. Hope my vocabulary and speaking is much better than just my typing. Anyways, have a nice time and see you next time.